So now, you people have seen many questions, many answers, a lot of programming. I am now going to teach you one of the smallest programs ever taught to you in this course, but one of the most complicated of all codes. In fact, the world still doesn't have an answer for this two-line code. It's a simple while condition and an if condition. That's it. You will see that the code gets done in less than quarter page, but the world still doesn't know an answer to it. So what's the question? The question is very simple. Input any number n. If the number n is even, make it into half. If the number is 10, make it 5. Okay. If it's even, that is. If it's even, make it by 2. If it is odd, let's say if it was 11, if it's odd, shoot that number up by 3n plus 1, which is if n is 11, make it 3 into 11, 33, plus 1, 34. Simple. If it's even, reduce it by half. If it's odd, increase it by 3 times the number and add 1 to it. Let us say we start with n equals 7. So 7 becomes into 3, 21, plus 1, 22. 22 is an even number, so you should halve it. So 22 becomes 11. 11 becomes, think about it, into 3 plus 1, 34. I'll be slightly fast now. 34 becomes 17. Why? You're halving it. Okay. 17 becomes 3n plus 1. 3 times 17, 51, plus 1, 52. 52 becomes 26. 26 becomes 13. 13 becomes 39 plus 1 is 40. 40 becomes 20. 20 is even, becomes 10. 10 is even, becomes 5. 5 is odd, becomes 16. 16 is even, becomes 8. And then 8 becomes 4. 4 becomes 2. 2 is even, so half of that becomes 1. 1 is odd, so into 3 plus 1 is 4. Again, we saw 4 already. So whenever you get 4, 4 becomes 2. 2 becomes 1. And 1 again becomes 4. You see, this is in an infinite loop. So what we do is we say, while the number is greater than 1, you do this. Do what? If the number is even, make it become half. The number is odd, make it become 3 times that number plus 1. So 7 had how many numbers? Count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20 steps. Right? 7 took 20 steps. Let us take some number, big number, like 256. How many steps will it take? Let us count. 256 is even. Half of that is 128. 128 is again even. Half of that is 64. Even again. 32. Even again. 16. Wow. Even once again. 8. Even again. 4. Even again. 2. And that then becomes 1. 1 is odd, so 1 becomes 4. Into 3 plus 1, 4, and then 4 becomes 2, 2 becomes 1, and you enter and you stop here. You see, a small number like 7 took such a long number of steps. A number like 256, how many steps did it take? Let me count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 steps. As opposed to more than 15 steps for 7. Correct? So, smaller the number doesn't mean smaller steps. Bigger the number doesn't mean bigger steps. In fact, this piece of code is so not understood. Given n, when will it stop? We still don't know. Right? This is famously called the 3n plus 1 problem. Google for it. There's a lot of references for this. 3n plus 1 problem, also called the Collatz conjecture. In fact, we don't even know whether this will ever stop. For some input, it might keep going on and on. It may never hit 421, 421. In both the cases, you saw it hit 421, but it needn't hit 421. You see? Google for it, read a lot about it, and know that when someone comes and gives you a long program and says he has done something very complicated, give that person a simple code like this and ask him to analyze what is happening. That will be a big googly for him. He will not really converge to a nice answer on what exactly is happening here. Okay, so that was fun looking at a question that is the smallest possible. See, we have given you very, very big programs that work and very, very small program like this that even the world doesn't know how to answer. So this programming world is very huge, very interesting, very fascinating. Sky is the limit. I hope you people have enjoyed the lectures given to you so far. So we are ending this course with a quick code on Collatz conjecture,